Alright, what's up guys? Had to give another video, and today basically what I'm going to be doing is comparing the SUICOKE MOTO-CABs to the SUICOKE MOTO-VS. So yeah, into it. Let's get into it. Alright, starting off with the SUICOKE CABs, or MOTO-CABs I guess. So you first look at it and it also has a vibram insole, but when you look at it and you get the two SUICOKEs together, you'll see the MOTO-VS actually has almost twice as thick sole, which is like, you don't even really notice it until you get them in hand and then actually put them on and then you feel it. So they're both a size 8, and honestly I bought the MOTO-CABs first, and then I bought the MOTO-VS second. And you know, I just wanted a black pair and a white pair because I love them. But main thing about the VS that is different is that it has the little Vibram little mini yellow or orangish logo right there. Also on it, you've got the leather interior kind of upper, I guess. So you also, like, a bad thing about the MOTO-VS is that you can kind of see that. If you wear black socks with these, or like any color socks, then basically you're gonna expect to get whatever color sock it is on this leather in here. I'm not sure exactly what leather it is. It's very soft, super comfortable. You can wear these for hours, honestly. And of course, everybody knows Vibram. Vibram is known for making some of the best soles when it comes to these shoes and sandals, so can't go wrong with them. Another thing about this has a actual cow leather upper. A lot of people think this is suede, but it's actually not. When you look at it, and if you look on the SUICOKE website at all the specs and everything of it, you'll see it's cow leather. But yeah, these are the SUICOKE MOTO-VS's. Basically, summary, they got the Vibram logo, they have the leather inside, they have the cow leather outside, I guess, and they have the thicker Vibram sole. Moving on, we got the MOTO-CABs, and the MOTO-CABs, there's one thing about these that I've noticed that I like since it has the much thinner sole. These are more of like beach shoes, I guess I'd say. Like, I'd wear them on a beach or something, or like just chilling around in my house. And these more like, they feel a lot more heavy duty, you know, like you can kind of wear these all day and they won't get, you know, uncomfortable, or your feet won't hurt or anything. So getting into it, main thing about the SUICOKE MOTO-CABs is that obviously the much slimmer sole, there's no Vibram insert, or not insert, there's no Vibram little tag right here, as you can see. It doesn't have a leather, inside. It's just filled with this sort of, I guess, foam kind of, and it has this canvas outside, which I'm not sure if you can tell in this lighting, but it's got that. And then you also got this, SUICOKE artificial little green tag right here. That's also not on the MOTO-VS's. Yeah, so basically I kind of beat the shit out of these. They're getting a little stained and shit, as you can see, but I'm gonna still get a ton of wear out of them, and they're still gonna do me really good. They're both a size 8, and something that I've noticed about them is that the this fits more like a size 8.5 or like a size 9. It's just a little bit big on me. I feel like I could have went for a 7.5 on these. And on the other hand, the MOTO-VS's, they actually fit more like a true to size 8. So if you don't know, then I usually buy an 8.5 in shoes. And if it's sandals or boots or anything, then I usually go for the 8. But these, I noticed, like, was almost perfect shape for my foot. So I can wear these almost all day. But you also got to put into mind that they have the leather inside, which is almost a little bit like, not like stiff, but whenever you're walking it, you notice it kind of has like more tension. Like, it's a little bit more stiffer than the MOTO-CABs, because these are just foam. So, you know, these can like bend and go all over the place and shit like that. And this leather is a little bit more stiffer, so whenever you're walking and your foot's going like this, you know, you feel it a little bit more. But yeah, that's basically it. The SUICOKEs versus the SUICOKE MOTO-CABs. I'll have a little video put in where I'll show what they look like on foot right now.
Celine in the match. Ooh, my bitch, she bad. Yeah, loving the feel. Count up a whole quarter mil. I remember when I cracked the seal. I remember when Enix peeled. Switch, it's a shame. I've been traffic, been switching your lanes. Hit your whole thing, she needed a cane. Love, hate, smoke, in the same. In the fisk, switching frames. Keep it true, we the same.
So now that I got that little thing put in the video, got that out of the way, I would say that I have to go with the MOTO-VS's over the MOTO-CABs simply because of the aesthetic of them and the leather inside and the thicker sole and just how much longer you can wear them compared to the MOTO-CABs. So yeah guys, for me, the MOTO-VS's are the way to go because of the leather and the thicker sole. I like it over the foam and canvas material and the thinner sole. If any of you guys wanted to know, I got a new little necklace right here, number 9 Fender guitar pick. I got it for like $150 on Grailed. Shout out Faust on Grailed. The hoodie we're wearing is an Eli Kong Reckless hoodie, or the Inevitable Demise. And it's really sick. It's this rhinestone pattern of this rib cage with this skeleton head in front of it in the middle. So that's super sick. Basically it, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video if y'all fuck with this. Hit me up on Instagram, raxx, R-I-X-X, Snapchat, FTP Gavin. Y'all be safe. Buy the right SUICOKEs.